Hi all. Today we'll be discussing about supportive psychotherapies. As we all know about a lot of other psychotherapies or mainstream psychotherapies like psychoanalytic therapy, behavioristic psychotherapy, humanistic psychotherapy, and many other newly invented psychotherapies, there are a set of psychotherapies called as supportive psychotherapies. As the term itself says, supportive psychotherapies support the major psychotherapies. For example, when you are using psychoanalytic therapy, whatever is discussed by psychoanalytic therapy of Sigmund Freud or Alfred Adler or Carl Jung will not complete the psychotherapy or the therapeutic session or the helping process without including or without involving some of the other components also. So, such techniques are called as supportive psychotherapies. These are mainly the therapeutic techniques used with major psychotherapies. For example, when you are using person-centered therapy, Carl Rogers mentions few of the basic concepts or techniques. With that, with the innovativeness of the therapist, if he or she tries to modify the therapy with using some other techniques which will help in the improvement of the client's well-being, then those techniques are called as supportive psychotherapy. So here, what are the objectives of using supportive psychotherapies or the techniques of supportive psychotherapy? Because we all know there are full-fledged psychotherapies like psychoanalytic therapy or person-centered therapy or gestalt therapy or existential therapy that explains in itself in full detail what to do, what are the basic concepts of human nature and also therapeutic techniques, goals of therapy or the process of therapy. It's discussed in a very nice manner and detailed manner in every mainstream therapy. But then, in using supportive psychotherapy, there are certain objectives of the therapist. The first major objective of using supportive psychotherapeutic techniques is to improve patient's self-esteem. Probably, when you are using the major psychotherapy or any of the major psychotherapy, you might require an additional technique in relation to the client's symptoms or client's development or progress that would help him or her in developing the concepts of self, like improving self-esteem or self-confidence, self-efficacy, self-concept and such things. So, for that you need a special technique specialized for that particular client only. So, in that cases you can use these supportive psychotherapeutic techniques. And also the second principle objective of using supportive psychotherapeutic techniques is to minimize or prevent recurrence of symptoms. No psychotherapy will promise you or promises the clients or the therapist that there won't be relapse in future. There won't be recurrence or once again there will not be the arrival of symptoms in the person. No therapy promises that. But then, that condition can be minimized by using supportive psychotherapeutic techniques. And the third major objective of using supportive psychotherapeutic techniques in addition to major psychotherapeutic techniques is to maximize patients' adaptive capacities. For example, every psychotherapy aims at helping the client to overcome from the distressful situation, to manage his or her stressful behaviors in a more productive manner, or to lead a very good life filled with healthy habits as well as healthy thoughts. But then, in order to do that, if a patient has experienced or going through rough time, be it in the field of relationship or family or academics or occasion or occupation, whatever it is, in that case it requires the patient to develop some of the adaptive skills or to adjust to the situation. He requires some of the skills, and those skills can be provided with the help of this supportive psychotherapeutic techniques. Coming to the goals of the patient in using these supportive psychotherapeutic techniques, it is mainly used, supportive psychotherapeutic techniques is mainly used to maintain or re-establish best possible level of functioning. means every individual has the capacity to function or live in a much better manner than he or she is living. So when there are, for that kind of living to his fulfilled ability, there are certain limitations that are put by the environment or the circumstances or personal thoughts and feelings. So to overcome such non-productive personal thoughts and feelings or environmental stresses, and to re-establish his or her functioning level in a best possible level, this supportive psychotherapeutic techniques can be used. And when it comes to the techniques used in supportive psychotherapy, there are different techniques, and depending on the client's symptoms or his coping ability and what kind of therapy you are or the therapist is using in dealing with the client, the supportive psychotherapeutic technique can be chosen. There are, here is a list of techniques of supportive psychotherapy. When we use this term supportive psychotherapy, it actually has to support the major psychotherapy. So the list of techniques goes like this, like guidance, pressure and coercion, reassurance, prestige suggestion, environmental manipulation, tension control and release, externalization of interest, persuasion, confession and ventilation. These are considered to be the major techniques of supportive psychotherapy. Here in this, you can notice that some of the techniques are nothing but the basic skills that are used in counseling. For example, it could be guidance, it could be reassurance, or it could be persuasion. Whereas some of the techniques have to be done or have to be given or used by someone else, an external member from the surrounding environment of the client. For example, it could be prestige suggestion, or it could be environmental manipulation, and so on. Whereas some techniques have to be used by the client himself, or the patient himself or herself, that is confession and ventilation. And there is also one technique that is related to the body of an individual, through which a person tries to acquire mental freeness, that is tension control and release. So like this the techniques of supportive psychotherapy includes a whole lot of it's a package filled with some of the things that can be done by the counselor, some techniques that can be used by the client himself or herself, and some techniques for which the help of others or the surrounding or the family members or the experts is required. So we will be discussing in future classes each of these techniques in detail, because as you can see here, guidance, reassurance, these are the basic skills required by any counselor for that matter. But still, being a specific technique of supportive psychotherapy, it holds its own importance. So we will see in the future classes each one of these techniques, how it is used as a supportive psychotherapy. But while using also, there are certain advantages and disadvantages. Those things also we'll be discussing. So this is about supportive psychotherapy, introduction to supportive psychotherapy. Thank you.